my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR by Info. In today's class, we are going to discuss one more important concept, that is the structure of centriole. See the centriole. Before going to see the centriole, we have to know a little bit about the microtubules. Already, I have discussed in the previous session the structure of microtubule and how microtubule profilament is formed and how all profilaments together that form the tubular structure that is called as a microtubule. And also I mentioned the doublet and triplet concept regarding to the microtubules. And actually I also mentioned the doublet and triplet structure which are present in the cilia and flagella. Is it right? Now we are going to see the structure of centriole. Okay. In the previous class, we have discussed the cilia and the flagella. Is it right? The cilia and the flagella, both that contains the similar structure. At the same time, the cilia flagella, that divide into two important parts, that is the basal body and flagella or cilia structure. Flagella or ciliary structure. Here, the cilia that contains basal body and flagella or ciliary structure. Here, the flagella ciliary structure that is made up with the doublet of microtubules. Doublet of microtubules, especially 9+2 category. Whereas, the basal body that is formed by the triplet of microtubules. This is a very, very important point. This point also very important for the present class. See, the triplet, actually we know very well the triplet of microtubules that contains the A, B, C. A microtubule that contains the 13 protofilaments and B that contains 10 and this is also 10. So, in this way that forms the three microtubule structures together that form the triplet of microtubule. Again, the each microtubule that contains the, it has a 13 protofilaments. I mentioned here like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. It has a 10 protofilaments like that. So, in this way, the basal body was formed. Now, we are going to see the structure of centriole. Centriole also formed by the triplet. Centriole also formed by the triplet structure, triplet of microtubule. Actually, we have to see the differences between the basal body and centrioles. Let us see the basal body and centrioles. The basal body that is present in the inside of cell. It is also present in inside of cell. But the number is vary from basal body to centriole. The centriole number in a cell is a 2. But the number of basal body in a cell is a vary from different organism to organism. For example, if you take cilia that contains the high number of ciliary structures. All those ciliary structures that is came from the basal body. Okay, that means number of ciliary structures outside that is contains the basal body. So, the number of cilia which is directly proportional to the number of basal body. Coming to the flagella. Flagella that contains the 1 to 5 in number. In a cell, 1 to 5 in number. Such cells that contains the 1 to 5 basal bodies. So, number is a vary here, but here is a number 2. Is it right? The size, coming to the size. Size is a basal body size that contains the triplet structure. It is a very large that contains 300 to 500 micrometers. Whereas, centrioles are very small that contains 2 to 5 micrometers in length. Size. Is it right? But the basal body and the centriolus both are differ in the these different types of functions and also structure, but they have the similar similar structure. They have similar structure in the basal body and also centriole. These are very important. The basal body that involved in the movement, whereas the centriole that involved in the cell division. So these are the very fundamental differences which are present in between the basal body and centriolus. Already I discussed the structure of basal body and cilia. In the present class we are going to see the structure of centrioles. Okay, let us start. So the centriole actually that contains the 9+0 structure. Actually cilia that contains the, we know very well, 9 doublets outside and cilia or flagella and 2 in the middle of the structure. But the centriole that contains the only 9 architecture that are present in outside but not present in the middle side. So let us see the structure. We know very well the centriole that contains the triplet microtubules.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and 9.
Okay. So here is the 9 microtubules in the form of triplet. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And here the positions are A, B, C, A, B, C, A, B, C, A, B, C, and A, B, C, A, B, C. So, in this way, it has the 3 different triplet and contains the 3 different microtubules A, B, C. Now, it forms the bonds. It forms the bonds AC bond. See, in this way. In this way, it forms the structures like this. So, these bonds we called as AC bonds. AC bonds. Again, see, beneath the A, there is a structure called a dense structure is present. The dense structure we called as a X body. This is called as a X body. Again, in between the 2 X bodies, there is a one more dense structure is there that is called as a Y body. Like this. Now, what happened? the dense X body that connected with the A subunit of the triplet microtubule, like this. Is it right? Now, the X body, sorry, the Y body that connected with the dense X bodies which are adjacent to each other, like this. See, it forms like this. Is it right? Again, the center part of this centriole that contains a part, the centrally that contains a part, it is very essential for the bonding. Now, what happened? The X body that forms a bond in between this structure. So, these structures, these bondings we called as our radial spokes. Radial spokes. Due to the presence of radial spokes, the centriole which is present in the cell, which is looking like a cartwheel shape. It is looking like cartwheel shape. This is a X body, this is a Y body. You have to remember. So, the A subunit that is present inside of the cell, whereas B, C that are outside of the centriole. Outside of the centriole. Okay, is it clear? So, in this way, the structure of centriole is present. The structure of centriole is present. Is it clear? Now, we are going to see the how centriole, which is functionally very essential for the cell division. These centrioles, two types of centrioles very perpendicular to the each other. For example, a centriole looking like this, it is also another centriole that is present in the perpendicular to the first one. This is the second one. The first one perpendicular to the second one. Second one very perpendicular to the first one. This is the structure which is present in the cell. Let us see actually cell division. Let us see the centriole involvement in the cell division. Okay. We have to know a brief account on the cell division. Actually, the cell division can occur in different stages, including the interphase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Is it right? These are the different phases. Again, interphase that contains the G1, S, G2 phases. Here, first of all, the synthesis or multiplication of centriole will be occur. What happened? First of all, initially, a cell, whatever the cell, that cell contains the two centrioles, that two centriole initially that is very nearer to the nucleus. These centriole, two centriole very perpendicular to each other. The first one perpendicular to second one perpendicular to the first one, like that, vice versa. Now, these centrioles in the G1 phase is normal. But when coming to the S phase nothing but synthetic phase or synthesis phase. In the synthesis phase, these centrioles get multiply into double and forms the like this. This is the one pair and this is the one pair. Now what happened? The G1 phase that enter into the G2 phase. In the G2 phase, these synthesized or multiplied centrioles enter into the maturation in the G2 phase. After G2 phase, the cell that enter into the prophase. Is it right? In the prophase, all the consequences that occur in the cell division can occur, and finally, the centriole which are formed in the these such cells that divided into two opposite poles, that enter into two opposite poles like this. For example, here is a one centriole, here is a one centriole, and that means the centrioles are two. Two centrioles are comes here and another two centrioles comes here in a single cell. Is it right? Now what happened in the metaphase? In the metaphase, these centrioles that produces this a fiber like structures made up of with the tubulin protein, that is called as a spindle fibers. Is it right? After the metaphase that forms the spindle fibers through these centrioles. In the anaphase, the spindle fibers which are formed in the metaphase get attached to the chromosomes. Let us see the actually cell division, the stage of anaphase. What happened in the metaphase? The centrioles which are present in the two opposite poles of the cell get producing the spindle fibers. Actually, such spindle fibers that are made up of with the microtubules. Each microtubule that contains the 13 protofilaments. There is no doublet and triplet, only that producing the mono microtubule structures containing 13 protofilaments like that. See, here is a centriole are present at the stage of anaphase. The centrioles that producing or synthesizing the different types of microtubules. The different types includes three types of microtubules are producing, in which the first one is the atrial, the second one is the kinetochore, the third one is a polar. Three different types of spindle fibers are produced. Let us see actually what are they. The atrial spindle fiber that is produced like this here at the poles. The second one is the kinetochore spindle fibers. The kinetochore spindle fiber actually those bound with the chromosomes. Let us see first of all the chromosome structures that are present in the equatorial plate of cell. Here is the three chromosome structures I drawn. These three chromosome structures actually that contains the two sister chromatids. Each chromosome that contains the two sister chromatids. Two sister chromatids means it is like this. These two are the separate chromosome. These two are the separated. So these chromosome actually that contains the center part. Center part that is called as a centromere. Actually, these centromere that contains the binding site. That binding site we called as a kinetochore. That binding site we called as a kinetochore. At the stage of anaphase, the chromosome which are arranged in a equatorial plate, such chromosomes contains the sister chromosomes. Such sister chromosomes contains the two individual kinetochore. One sister chromosome that contains the one chromosome that contains the one kinetochore, another chromosome that contains the another kinetochore, both together that forms the sister chromatin. Now what happened? The kinetochore spindle fibers which are produced by the centrioles which are present in the two different poles. Actually, the centrioles which are present in the two different poles, that centriole producing the spindle fibers, that's why that site is, it is called as a microtubule organizing center. Microtubule organizing center, MTOC. Now, what happened? Let us see. Kinetochore spindle fibers are producing here, and that kinetochore spindle fibers that bind to the
kinetochore region of the sister chromatid, like this. Is it clear?
Now what happened?
After binding of the
this kinetochore spindle fiber to the kinetochore, after the stage of anaphase that enter into the telophase, these chromosomes get separated. These chromosomes, sister chromosomes, get separated into two opposite poles like this. These chromosomes that enter into,
actually we have to write here like this. What happened? These are enter into like this. The process, what it segregating to the opposite pole of chromosomes,
we called as a chromosomal segregation. The separation of chromosomes, separation of sister chromosomes. The separation of sister chromosomes can be done by the important spindle fiber, such spindle fiber which are made up of with the tubulin protein.
It is a more important.
Actually, we are studying the tubulins. Is it right? Okay. Here, the tubulin is very essential for the segregation of chromosomes. Such segregation of chromosomes are directly involved in the centrioles. Such centrioles that contains the triplet structure of microtubules. Already, we have discussed. So, in this way, these two are the atrial spindle fibers and kinetochore spindle fibers. Let us see the polar spindle fibers. Actually, these polar spindle fibers that also came from the organizing center, but these polar spindle fiber are overlapping each other like this. This is from side 1 and this is from side 2. Is it right? The side 2 and side 1, those two are the overlapping here. This overlap also very essential for the segregation of chromosomes with the enzymes or proteins called as the kinases. I will give very clear clarity about the kinases and their functions in the segregation of chromosomes and separation of chromosomes and also completion of cell division in the cell division classes separately. Okay. So, in this way, the microtubules are produced by the what MTOC, that MTOC that contains the centrioles. Is it right? This is all about the centrioles and its involvement in the cell division. Is it clear? I hope this is a very clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Like, share and comment. Thank you.